Hello students, myself Ankita Best, and today we are going to start our new chapter of GK, which is chapter number 18, The Great Deserts. So students, let's start reading this chapter. Desert is a barren and dry region incapable of supporting any considerable population or vegetation without an artificial water supply. Here we are giving some famous desert opposite to their country names. Let's read and know about them. So students, what are desert? Desert is the barren land or dry region where water is not available without any artificial water supply. So because of they don't have any water, they are not capable to support any population or any vegetations. So there are so many deserts present in our world. Some of them are given here. We have to know what are these deserts and where they are located. So students, let's read. First one is Sahara Desert present in North Africa. Second one is Great Australian Desert, which is present in West Australia. Third is Arabian. It is present in Saudi Arabia. Fourth one is Gobi. Present in Mongolia. Fifth one is Kalahari, and it is present on Botswana. Sixth one is Taklamakan, Uyghur Autonomous Region of Xinjiang, China. Seventh one is Karakum, Southwest Turkmenistan. Eighth is Thar, Northwest India and Pakistan. Ninth one is Atacama, North Chile. 10th is Great Salt, it present in Iran. 11th is Colorado, California. 12th is Rub al-Khali, Southern Arabia. 13th is Great Sandy, Australia. 14th one is Kaizalkum, Uzbekistan. And 15th and last one is Nubian, Sudan. So students, these are some great deserts which are present in different parts of the world. So now we have to move to our next chapter, which is chapter number 19, World's Superlatives. So students, let's start reading. Our world is full of superlative things, some of them natural and some made by men. Here we are giving some superlative, the largest, smallest, highest, longest, biggest, etc. Let's read and know about them. So student, word superlatives, in this chapter we will discuss about the smallest things, highest things, longest, shortest, every kind of superlative things made by natural or made by men in this chapter. So let's read. First is largest country. So largest country in area wise is in world Russia. Second one is the smallest country. Vatican City is the smallest country in the world. Third is most populous city. Most populous city is Tokyo, Japan. Populous means where the population is very high. Fourth one is most populous country. So most populous country is China. Largest democratic country is India. Sixth one is largest church is present in Brasilia of St. Peter, Vatican City. Seventh is largest stadium is present in Estrevo Stadium, Paraguay. Eighth is largest deepest ocean. So largest deepest ocean is Pacific Ocean. Largest freshwater lake present in Lake Superior, Canada. Biggest lake is Caspian Sea. 11th is largest delta. Largest delta is Sundarbans, India. Biggest island is Greenland. 13th is longest river. Nile, Egypt. Nile is the longest river in the world. Highest waterfall. So Angel Falls, Venezuela is the highest waterfall. 15th one is tallest tower. Tokyo Sky Tree, Japan is the tallest tower. Tallest building. Burj Khalifa, Dubai is a tallest building. So now we have to read our fact 5. So Mount Everest is the highest mountain in the world. So students, these are our superlatives. Now we have to move over next chapter, which is chapter number 20, international agencies. So let's read. These agencies are international organizations created by agreement between countries to perform various activities. The agencies are related to the UNO through special agreement. So students, in this chapter we will read some international. These agencies are organized and created by the UN. OE means United Nations Organization. So let's read what are the agency and where their headquarters are. So first is Food and Agriculture Organization. It is present in Rome. The headquarters of World Bank is in Washington. Now International Labour Organization, their headquarters are present in Geneva. International Maritime Organization, which is in London. International Monetary Fund, Washington. UNESCO, Paris. Seventh one is World Health Organization. Its headquarters is in Geneva. Eighth is International Atomic Energy Agency, Vienna. Ninth is UNICEF. Its headquarters is in New York. 10th is United Nations Environmental Program, Nairobi. 11th is World Meteorological Organization. Here its headquarters is in Geneva. Next is Universal Postal Union. Its headquarters is in Bern. Next is International Civil Aviation Organization and its headquarters is in Montreal. 14th is International Development Association and its headquarters is in Washington. 15 is UN Industrial Development Organization, Vienna. Last is UNESCO. The full form of UNESCO is United Nations Education, Scientific and Cultural Organization. Next is UNICEF. UNICEF's full form is United Nations Child Fund. So students, these are our international agencies and their headquarters. Now we have to move to the next chapter, which is chapter number 21, airlines. Flights are operated by many companies all over the world. Let's have a look the popular airlines from which country they are associated with. So students, in this chapter we will read the names of different airlines and their associated country. First is Continental Airlines, USA. Air Canada, associated with Canada. US Airways, connected with USA. Air France, related to France. British Airways, UK. KLM, Netherlands. Lufthansa, Germany. Emirates, UAE. Gulf Air, Bahrain. Kuwait Airways, Kuwait. Royal Wings, Jordan. GOL, Brazil. Air Mauritius, Mauritius. Africa Airways, Libya. South African Airways, South Africa. China Southern Airlines, China. Air India, India. Cathay Pacific, China. Garuda, Indonesia. Japan Airlines, Japan. Georgian Airlines, Georgia. Thai Airways, Thailand. Royal Brunei. Pacific Air, Philippines. Aeroflot, Russia. Qantas, Australia. Virgin Blue, Australia. Air New Zealand, New Zealand. So students, these are some airlines and their related or associated countries. So let's move to our next chapter, which is important official residence. An official residence is a residence at which the head of the state, head of the government of other senior figures officially reside. The residence is an important part of country's history. Place or fortress used by kings or emperors for countries. Here we are giving information about some famous official residence in the world. Let's read and learn about them. So students, in this chapter we will read some important officials' residence. What are official? Officials are the highest government officials or officers of different countries. So let's read about their residence. So students, for the officials who are in higher positions, the government has given them residence for their security and their assistant and service for the country. So few of them are very famous, so we will read about them in this chapter. So let's start. First one is the Moscow Kremlin is a huge fortified complex which includes four palaces, four cathedrals and the enclosing Kremlin wall with Kremlin tower. So students, the Moscow Kremlin is a huge building. Inside it, four palaces and four cathedrals are present. So students, in Russia, Kremlin word is used for fort. So this fort is having fort walls and fort towers also. So students, now we have to move to our next important official residence. So student, next is our the White House. The White House in Washington DC is the official residence and office of the President of the United States. So students, this is the official residence and office of President of the United States, and it is present in Washington DC, America. So let's move to our next residence, which is Buckingham Palace. Buckingham Palace in London is the main residence of Queen Elizabeth II, although it is owned by the British state and is not the monarch's personal property. So student, Buckingham Palace in London is the residence for the Queen Elizabeth II, although it is not owned by the Queen or monarch person or the royal persons, it is the property of British state or government. Official residence, which is the Apostolic Palace. The Apostolic Palace, Italian Palazzo Apostolico, is the official residence of Pope, which is located in Vatican City. So students, it is the official residence for the Pope who lives in Vatican City. So student, next is our in the list is the Potla Palace. The Potla Palace in Lhasa, Tibet Autonomous Region, was the chief residence of Dalai Lama. So students, Potla Palace in Lhasa is the resident of Tibet Autonomous Region chief, who is Dalai Lama. So students, let's move to our next residence, which is the Rashtrapati Bhavan. The Rashtrapati Bhavan is the official home of the President of India. So students, our President of India has to live in Rashtrapati Bhavan, Delhi. So students, these are some important official residences. Now students, we have completed the chapter. I hope you understand. Thank you.